with this momentum that we are going to talk about, it relates to a question that I asked. It relates to a question I asked early last week. I was using this as a conservation of energy demo, and in some sense, you saw that when I. Can everyone see this okay? Yes. In some sense, you saw that when I lift a ball to one side and let go, then only one ball comes out the other end, and it reaches the about same height that this started out from. So when I let go here, this whole thing is starting out with some amount of energy, and that amount of energy is conserved through this interaction. So when this comes in and strikes, then roughly speaking, this is going out to about the same height, comes back, and one ball comes out, right? And if I do it with two balls, so that now I double the mass, then looking at this formula for gravitational potential energy, we should expect that there's now double the amount of energy. And when you look at the interaction you see reflects that there's double the amount of energy. So when this comes in and hits, there's now two balls coming out. Now, I asked a question last time that you didn't really have tools to answer. So if all we care about is conservation of energy, then why doesn't this happen? Why doesn't it happen so that when I pull these two balls to the side and let go, why doesn't it happen so that after they hit, only one ball comes out with the energy of both balls? Like, that would conserve energy. If that's what you saw happen, that when these two balls came and hit, only one ball came out and reached this height, that would conserve energy. But that doesn't happen. And what we sort of say in physics is that when you see something that could have happened but doesn't happen, that means there must be some law that's forbidding it. So there must be some other thing that has to be conserved so that when this comes and hits, that one ball coming out with some appropriate amount of speed so that it reaches this height, that doesn't happen. Because this interaction here is obeying some other conservation law beyond conservation of energy. So what you see here is something that can happen only when this is something that happens because this has to obey all the conservation laws. And that's what we are going to start talking about today.